Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to use Microsoft Excel Power Query to convert the JSON data to a Excel sheet. Most of the time while working with data, we may have the scenario to convert JSON data to a Excel format. The first option to consider is converting through online tools. But this is not the recommended option if the data is sensitive. The other option is using some tools or apps. Some of the tools require licensing to use it. Also, unknown external tools may not be the recommended option for sensitive data. Power Query for Excel is a data transformation and data preparation engine. Power Query comes with a graphical interface for getting data from sources and a Power Query editor for applying transformations. Power Query for Excel supports hundreds of data sources with built-in connectors. Let us now see how to use Excel Power Query to convert the JSON data to a Excel sheet. I have a sample JSON file. Let me show you. This is my sample JSON data. So this is a array of data, JSON array with two objects in it. This is a personal data. If you see here, this is a basic data. Then other one thing is like address. Address is a object again with address details. Then phone numbers, it's a again array inside object. Location is an array of string. So now let's see how to convert this. First up, open the Excel. Okay, click on data, then get data from file. You have multiple options. Select from JSON. Select the sample file, sample1.json. Now the Power Query editor is opened if the JSON file is valid. If the editor is not opened, then validate the file and reload it. Okay, so it's listing all the records, like our JSON had only two records, array of two records. So it's listing two, otherwise it will display all the data, available data. Now let's convert this into a table. So click on this to table. Okay, go with the default value. That's fine. Yeah, it's converted into table. So here if you see, it's a column one. This is the prefix value. Will get appended on each column name in the Excel sheet. So I want to change this column one to maybe personal data. This is fine. Yeah, now if you click on this, it will list out all the available columns. If you want to unselect some column, you can unselect. I want all the column in the Excel sheet. So I'm going with that. Click OK. It converted into a table and displaying all the basic data. If you see here, address, phone numbers and location. So this is all specific data because address is a of type again object. It's a record. Then phone numbers are array of object. Then location is an array of strings. So personal address, go here, click on here. It will again display all the available columns. So if you want all the columns, leave it, otherwise unselect. Click OK. Yeah, it again expanded those values. If you see personal data dot address dot city. Now if I go to the last one, location, this is of array of string. So you have two values, expand to new rows and extract values. Expand to new rows means it will create a duplicate row. And this value is going to be different for that row, specific row. Extract value means you can extract that array value. Click on extract value. It will ask you the delimiter. I'm going with the comma. Then click OK. See, if you see here, it's appended like comma appended. It is a delimited with comma, MN and NYC, second row. Now the phone numbers, it's again array of object. If you go here, you can't use the extract value here because it's not a, it's again an object. So you need to do a expand to new rows. So it's expanded. That's what I already told, like it created a duplicate row because the second row, personal data row, test two, like first name, it's having a two phone numbers. So if I go to the sample file, this second record having two phone numbers. So that's why it's like duplicated. The test second record is duplicated. Now it's of again record type. So for that, even click on here. Two columns are there. So I want both. Click OK. Yeah. Now if you see, home, mobile. So this row is duplicated. This is the only different value. Now the table is ready. click on close and load. So before that, one more thing, like if you want to do some transformation, you can do here. Just right click, do a transform. You can lowercase, uppercase, trim, clean, length, whatever you want, you can do it. Also, like if you want, you can add a column, conditional columns, and all those things. So once everything is done, click on close and load. Yeah, the JSON data is now converted into Excel. If you see here, like let me close this. Yeah, so it's all the data is there. Personal data, yeah, these three rows are there. Yeah, this is very useful whenever we want to convert the JSON data quickly into Excel without depending on any external tools. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.